绍我们的读经进度。我们这个礼拜在撒母耳记上十七章的前后。
According to our Bible reading schedule, we are reading the chapters near First Samuel chapter 17.
那在撒母耳记上，我们可以看到两个王，一个是扫罗，一个是大卫。
In First Samuel, we learn about two kings, namely Saul and David.
那在十七章的前后，我们特别十六章，我们可以看出来为什么神不继续用扫罗，那为什么神要用大卫。
In the chapters near chapter 17, especially chapter 16, we understand why God chose David instead of Saul.
那这有一个非常重要的，就是神在用一个人，神最看重什么。
And an important lesson in this is what does God look at? What is the most important factor that God looks at?
那这也是我们要侍奉神一种非常重要预备自己的方向。
And this serves as a goal for us who want to serve God and prepare ourselves.
我们看撒母耳记上十六章。
Please turn to 1 Samuel chapter 16.
撒母耳记上十六章。
1 Samuel chapter 16.
第六节第七节
Verses 6 and 7. Verse 6, so it was when they came that he looked at Eliab and said, surely the Lord's anointed is before him. 7, but the Lord said to Samuel, do not look at his appearance or at his physical stature, because I have refused him. But the Lord does not see as man sees. For man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart.
在这里神叫撒母耳到耶西的家去高一个人来 接续扫罗做王。
The Lord told Samuel to go to the house of Jesse to anoint someone to be king.
那撒母耳到了耶西的家，他看见有一个孩子就是以利甲，他就觉得说这个一定是王。
When Samuel arrived at Jesse's house, he was presented one of the sons whose name was Eliab, and he thought this was surely the Lord's anointed.
那第七节神说不是他。
But in verse 7, the Lord told him it was not so.
那为什么撒母耳他是神人，他会感觉到是他，那神又觉得说不是他？
Samuel was a man of God. Why was it that he was mistaken about the Lord's choice?
那我们就看出来，人看人跟神看人重点不一样。
This tells us that what man looks at is very different from what God looks at.
所以第七节，神对撒母耳说，不要看他的外貌跟身材高大。
The Lord said to Samuel in verse 7, do not look at his appearance or at his physical stature.
所以很显然，撒母耳要高他当王，因为他看到他的外貌还有他身材高大，看起来很像王。
Evidently, Samuel, the reason Samuel thought that Eliab was going to be the king was that he looked at his appearance and his physical stature because he was tall.
但是神说这地方讲神不像人看人，人看外貌，神看内心。
Then the Lord said, the Lord does not see as man sees, for man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart.
可见神要用一个人，最重要是他的心。
Therefore, when God wants to use someone, the most important thing he looks at is his heart.
那人最难改变的也是心。
But the heart is also the most difficult thing to change.
在使徒行传第一章，主耶稣升天以后，门徒要找一个人来接续犹大当使徒。
In Acts chapter 1, we read how after the Lord's ascension, the disciples wanted to choose someone to replace Judas.
然后他们就定一个条件，必须从主耶稣开始传道，一直到他升天的时候，常常跟我们在一起。
And they listed out some criteria, which included that this person must be always among them from the time that the Lord Jesus was with them until his ascension.
也就是说，这一个人必须是跟过耶稣的一个人。
In other words, this candidate must be someone who had followed the Lord Jesus.
就找到两个人，他符合这个外在的条件，跟耶稣跟到底。
And they were able to identify two candidates who fit these criteria because both of them have followed the Lord Jesus to the end.
但是这个门徒啊, 他就向神祷告,
but then the disciples continued to pray to God.
说你知道万人的心啊, 求你啊, 让我们啊, 来选择一个你所要用的人。
And they said to God, Lord, you know the hearts of men, so please select the person that you will.
那个时候没有圣灵感动啊，所以用抽签的。
At that time, they had not received the indwelling spirit, so they used the casting of lots.
所以可见呢，当时跟过主耶稣的这些使徒，他也知道神用人最重要看他的心。
Therefore, even the disciples of the Lord Jesus understood that God looks at the heart when He chooses to use someone.
那既然神不用扫罗，那一定。 扫罗有哪一点神不喜欢？
And the fact that God rejected Saul tells us that there was something about Saul that the Lord was very displeased with.
也就是说，他的心里面有一点很大的缺点呢，大到神不愿意他当王。
In other words, Saul's heart must have some very serious shortcoming to the point that God rejected him.
好，我们看撒母耳记上的十五章。
Please read 1 Samuel chapter 15.
撒母耳记上十五章22节23节。
First Samuel chapter 15 verses 22 and 23. 22. So Samuel said, "Has the Lord as great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices as in obeying the voice of the Lord? Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to heed than the fat of rams." 23. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry. Because you have rejected the word of the Lord, He also has rejected you from being king.
这个地方说听命胜于献祭。
To obey is better than sacrifice.
那顺从胜于公羊的脂油。
And to heed than the fat of rams.
这个献祭公羊的脂油都是一种外表上在神面前的一种奉献。
Both a sacrifice and the fat of rams are an offering to God externally.
所以以色列人有的人，他的信仰到最后就觉得，我只要有守节，我只要有献祭，那我大概就是一个不错的神的选民。
Many of the Israelites thought that as long as they offer something external to God, they were considered good people of God.
但是信仰是我们跟神的关系。
However, our faith is a relationship that we have with God.
常常聚会奉献十一捐，当然这很重要。
Of course, it is important to attend service regularly and offer tithes.
但是神所看重的是他的内心。
But what God looks at and what is even more important is His heart.
所以神要什么？这里讲听命跟顺从。
So what does God look for according to this verse? To obey and to heed.
那听命的相反就是悖逆。The
opposite of obey is rebellion.
悖逆跟行邪术一样。And
rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft.
那这个行邪术就很严重了。Witchcraft
is a very serious sin.
我们信主久了，我们大家都知道行邪术这很严重，我们一定不可以做。行邪术是跟交鬼啊。
Those of us who have believed for a long time understand that witchcraft is definitely something we should abstain from because it is a communion with the devil.
但是有时候我们却忘记了，我们从心里面违抗神。
But sometimes we may forget and we may rebel against God from our hearts.
我明明知道这不对，我还是要去做。
Even though we know that something is wrong, we continue to do it.
我明明知道这个对，我还是不愿意做。
And even though I know that something is right, I still do not do it.
那这个在神面前，这个心呢，神就不喜欢这样的心。
And God does not like that kind of heart in us.
那下面说，顽梗的罪与拜偶像一样。
And next, stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry.
顽梗如果看英文， stubborn就是说固执，这个跟拜偶像一样。
Stubbornness is like idolatry.
就是说我们自己的意见，我就坚持到底，我就是不变。
In other words, if we insist on our own opinions and do not change whatever the circumstance.
虽然神，我们知道神是最大的，我们是微臣。
even though we know that God is the greatest and we are but dust.
但是神要我做的，我就是不做，我很难改变我自己。
We may refuse to do what God wants us to do, and we are unwilling or we find it difficult to change ourselves.
那这种顽梗啊，跟啊拜偶像一样。
And stubbornness is actually just like idolatry.
那其实啊，这两句话是在形容扫罗。
These two statements are a description of King Saul.
那到底扫罗做错了什么事？
What exactly had Saul done wrong?
如果我们看十五章。
If we turn to chapter 15,
这个十五章第一节先讲到扫罗跟神的关系。
The beginning of chapter 15 tells us about Saul's relationship with the Lord.
十五章第一节。
Verse 1, Samuel also said to Saul, the Lord sent me to anoint you king over his people, over Israel. Now therefore, heed the voice of the words of the Lord.
这个地方讲哦，神高你做王治理百姓。
Samuel said, the Lord anoints you king over his people.
所以你是在万民之上。
And he makes you over Israel.
但是你要听从神。
But you must heed the voice of the words of the Lord.
在你的上面还有一个比你大的，就是神。
Because there is someone greater than you who is above you, and that is the Lord.
所以这有一个次序哦，神、你、百姓。
Therefore, there is a hierarchy. The Lord, then the king, then the people.
那这个次序讲清楚了，那第二个就下达一件事情给他做。
And having clarified this hierarchy, the Lord then issued a command for Saul.
就在做事情当中就看出来到底神有没有在你上面。
And in carrying out what the Lord commands you, it will become clear whether God, you really consider God to be above you.
所以从第二节跟第三节。
And we can look at verses 2 and 3.
这讲亚玛利人要全部把他杀掉，连小孩子吃的奶全部都要杀掉，等于就把他灭种了。
The Lord commanded Saul to utterly destroy all of the Amalekites, including men, women, infants, and nursing children.
那如果我们用世俗的眼光来看，哇，这个神很残忍。
From a worldly perspective, we may judge that God is too cruel.
但是如果我们以神的眼光来看，
But if we look at it from God's perspective, God is the greatest.
神要带领他的选民出埃及进到迦南。
He wished to bring his people out of Egypt into Canaan.
那亚玛利人在旷野专门要杀那些走在后面的、走不动的、软弱的。
Yet the Amalekites always attacked the Israelites from behind, especially targeting those who were falling behind or who were weak.
那如果亚玛利人没有杀掉，他会把神的百姓杀掉。
If the Amalekites were not annihilated, they would have annihilated the people of God.
当然，亚玛利人现在代表就是情欲。
Today, the Amalekites are symbolic of our lusts.
要完全把它除掉。
Which we must remove completely.
我们不除掉情欲，情欲会除掉我们。
If we do not remove our lusts will annihilate us.
好，那现在扫罗就去执行这个命令。
Then Saul went and executed the Lord's command.
他就有个人的喜好来取代一部分神的命令。
However, he used his personal preference to replace part of the Lord's command.
所以在第八节。
Verse 8. He also took Agag, king of the Amalekites, alive and utterly destroyed all the people with the edge of the sword.
所以他抓了亚玛利王，然后第九节。
Verse 9.
他爱惜雅甲，也爱惜上他的牛羊牛犊，并一切美物，不肯灭绝。
He spared Agag and the best of the sheep, the oxen, the fatlings, the lambs, and all that was good, and were unwilling to utterly destroy them.
所以在他的眼中啊，他有觉得这个是好的，然后这个王哦是好的，所以他把他留下来。
In his eyes, he had things that he favored, including the king and the best of the things, so he decided to spare them.
但是他这样做的时候，他已经没有听命，他已经没有顺从。
But in doing so, he failed to obey and to heed.
所以在神面前，这个严重到神不能够再继续用他。
So such actions were such a serious offense against the Lord to the point that the Lord could not use him anymore.
所以后来他就战死在战场上。
And eventually Saul died in the battlefield.
还没有死以前呢，邪灵就进到他里面了。
And before his death, the evil spirit entered him.
好，那现在大卫到底神又看重他什么？
On the contrary, what was it in David that God highly esteemed?
因为神看人看心嘛，到底大卫什么心蒙神看重？
God looks at a man's heart. So what is it in David's heart that found favor with the Lord?
我们看使徒行传十三章。
Please turn to Acts chapter 13.
使徒行传十三章。
Acts chapter
13. 22节。
Verse 22.
使徒行传十三章二十二节。
Acts 13:22, and when he had removed him, he raised up for them David as king, to whom also he gave testimony and said, I have found David the son of Jesse, a man after my own heart, who will do all my will.
这个地方说大卫他是合我心意的人。
This verse describes David as a man after God's own heart.
他是合神的心啊，这神喜欢他。
He was a man after God's own heart. Therefore, God was pleased with him.
人如果做到神喜欢哦，这个人真的是一生哦没有缺乏。
If a person is able to conduct his life to the point that God is pleased with him, then he would never be wanting for the rest of his life.
那什么叫做合神心意呢？
But what does it mean to be after God's own heart?
那下面说，凡事要遵行我的旨意。
The last part of the verse says, "Who will do all my will?"
我们人有人的意思。
As human beings, we have our own will.
神有神的意思。
But God also has His will.
那我们愿意把自己的意思拿开，然后高举神的意思。
Are we willing to set aside our own will and exalt the will of God?
有时候我们会经历损失。
But to do that, sometimes we have to undergo loss.
有时候我们经历这个往下降。
We have to experience decline.
有时候会经历痛苦。
Sometimes we experience pain.
所以凡事要遵行神的旨意在那个过程当中不一定是很好受的。
So the process of determining and carrying out God's determining to carry out God's will is not pleasant all the time.
我们看保罗的侍奉。
We can look at Paul's ministry.
受苦很多。
He suffered a great deal.
就是要遵行神的旨意。
In order to carry out the Lord's will.
要把神托付的做完。
So that he can complete his mission.
主耶稣来世界。
The Lord Jesus came to this world.
神定对他有旨意。
Because God had given him a will.
他也是要把这个做完。
And the Lord had to complete his mission.
所以大卫神会用他。
The reason God used David.
因为他存心要尊神为大，要遵行神的旨意，讨神喜欢。
Was that he was wholeheartedly wanting to magnify the will of God and to please God.
好，那我们进到十七章，撒母耳记上十七章来看。实际发生的事情，大卫是怎么来讨神喜欢。
Now we will go into chapter 7 of 1 Samuel to look at how exactly David pleased the Lord.
我们看撒母耳记上十七章。
1 Samuel chapter 17.
撒母耳记上十七章。第二十六节，请读。
Verse 26, 1 Samuel 17, verse 26. Then David spoke to the man who stood by him, saying, What shall be done for the man who kills this Philistine and takes away the reproach from Israel? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine that he should defy the armies of the living God?
这个大卫照他爸爸的吩咐要去看他三个哥哥。
As instructed by his father, David went and went to see his three older brothers.
结果他就看到非利士人有一个巨人哥利亚，人高马大，在向以色列百姓挑战。
While he was there, he noticed this giant Goliath who challenged the Israelite army.
那以色列百姓一看到哥利亚，每个都很害怕，都躲起来。
The army of Israel was so afraid of the giant Goliath that all of them fled.
那如果我们看十一节，
verse 11.
扫罗跟以色列人听见非利士人这些话，就惊慌极其害怕。
When Saul and all Israel heard these words of the Philistine, they were dismayed and greatly afraid.
那这些神的选民是拜真神，又真又活的神。
These were the chosen people of God. They worshipped the true and living God.
那一个又真又活的神的这些百姓啊，竟然怕一个哥利亚。
But who would have expected that the people who worshipped the true and living God were so afraid of Goliath?
那这个不但是他们的羞耻，这也是神得不到荣耀。
This was a disgrace both for the people and for God.
大家不敢出来。
None of them dared to stand up.
但是这个大卫看到这个事情。
But when David saw the situation,
他就受不了了。
He could not bear it.
所以这就说，这是谁啊？竟敢向永生的神军队骂阵。
So he said, who is this dares to defy the army of the Lord?
这个大卫受不了，不是他个人的原因啊。
And David was not enraged or indignant because of personal reasons.
因为最危险的时刻常常会出英雄。
Because crisis often produces a hero.
所以他的哥哥对他的解释就是这样。
And this was his brother's way of reading the situation.
所以我们看28节。
Verse 28. Now Eliab, his oldest brother, heard when he spoke to the men, and Eliab's anger was aroused against David, and he said, Why did you come down here? And with whom have you left those few sheep in the wilderness? I know your pride and the insolence of your heart, for you have come down to see the battle.
这说你要来看征战。
His brother accused him of coming down to see the battle.
那如果他哥哥看他要出去打哥利亚，很可能就说他要立功啊，要出名。
He probably thought that David wanted to become a hero and win the man's praise.
所以很多人很勇敢的要做事情，到最后心里的最深处是为着出名立功。
Many people do courageous things, but ultimately for the purpose of winning fame.
所以中国有个要立德立功立言。
So there's a Chinese saying that you have to establish your own virtues, your own merits, and your own words.
不管是立德立功立言，立到最后还是要把自己出名，在历史留名。
In other words, you want to be someone who is well known in history.
如果我们的侍奉，
but if our ministry
到最后是为着留名。
Is ultimately for the sake of leaving behind a name.
那在我们心里面的最深处，我们就没有办法得到神喜欢。
Then we cannot please the Lord in the depth of our heart.
但是这只是我们跟神的关系，心的最深处没有人看得出来。
But this is something that is personal between us and God, and is in the bottom of our heart that other people cannot see.
但是这个大卫他最深处就是要除掉。以色列百姓的这种耻辱，要上神的名得到荣耀。
But in the bottom of David's heart, his intention was to remove this disgrace for Israel and to bring glory to God's name.
我们看十七章的四十六节。
Let's read chapter 17, verse 46. Chapter 17, verse 46. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hand, and I will strike you and take your head from you.And this day I will give the carcasses of the camp of the Philistines to the birds of the air and the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel.
说要是天下人知道以色列中有神。
That all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel.
有时候我们在路旁看到一些事情。
Sometimes we may see some happenings on the street.
有时候我们自然的感觉就赶快走，不要跟这个麻烦扯上去。
If we see people getting in trouble, we want to stay as far away as possible.
这是人的常情。
And this is human instinct.
但是这个神的事情不一样。
But when it comes to matters of God, it's different.
如果我们看到事情会让神的名羞辱。
If we see something that could bring shame to God's name,
那我们就跟自己的事情一样，赶快走，不要惹上事情。
And if we, in that situation, choose to just go away and feel an act if it's nothing to do with us,
那这样，在神看起来，这个心态没有办法蒙神悦纳。
then such attitude will not please the Lord.
所以大卫他看到神的名受到羞辱。
When David saw how the name of the Lord was disgraced,
他就很想要打死哥利亚, 要让到处人都知道以色列中有一个神。
All he wanted to do was defeat this Goliath so that all Israel, all everyone may know that there is God in Israel.
所以我们所做的如果心里最深处是为让神得荣耀, 这是美的。
Therefore, if our intention in the bottom of our heart is to bring glory to God, then that is something wonderful.
这是神喜欢的。
It is something that pleases God.
但是要达到神的名得到荣耀, 有时候要很大的牺牲。
But to bring the glory to God's name, we need to make a great sacrifice sometimes.
所以你看,大卫去战哥利亚, 随时都有可能被杀掉。
It was a great risk of being killed for David to challenge, to stand up to Goliath.
所以当大卫要出去的时候,哥利亚怎么讲?
So when David stepped forward, what did Goliath say?
哥利亚根本就看不起他。
He completely despised David.
这个算什么?一个小孩子来要打我。
What is this? A boy wanting to kill me?
所以我们就可以见到说这个其实危险很大。
So it was a very grave danger for David.
所以有时候我们常常看这个使徒行传啊, 当时使徒在传福音。
When we look at the Acts of the Apostles, how the Apostles preached the gospel in those days.
神的国要扩张, 这是神的旨意。
It is God's will for his kingdom to expand.
福音传开。
And for the gospel to be spread.
百姓增加,
and for God's people to increase.
福音传开,
and for the gospel to expand.
神迹奇事显明,
and for the signs and miracles to abound.
神得到荣耀,
and for God's name to be glorified.
这个原来是神的旨意,
this is God's will.
但是,
however,
我们看到当时使徒在传福音, 经历很多苦难,
when we read about how the apostles actually preached the gospel, they underwent many kinds of afflictions.
所以我们今天啊, 为着神的工作, 为着神的荣耀,
therefore today, for the sake of God's work and for the sake of God's glory,
我们来付出牺牲, 奉献,
let us make sacrifices and let us offer ourselves.
这个心啊, 就是神所悦纳, 就是大卫的心。
And this is the heart of David that God desires.
那这个大卫他一个小孩子, 到底他是凭什么他敢面对哥利亚呢?
What made this child David so courageous to be willing to face Goliath?
所以有时候我们常常觉得我算不了什么。
Sometimes we feel that we are nothing.
所以什么都没有做。
So we end up doing nothing.
有的人很谦卑, 谦卑到什么都没有做。
Some people are so humble to the point that they don't do anything.
这个我也不会, 那个也不会, 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 什么都不会。
I don't know how to do this, I don't know how to do that, I don't know how to do anything.
扫地我也不会, 洗碗我也不会, 什么我在, 什么都不会。
I don't know how to sweep, I don't know how to wash the dishes, so I don't know anything.
其实我们虽然算不了什么,
even though we are useless,
但是如果我们愿意被神所用,
If we're willing to be used by God,
神能够透过我们做出非常荣耀神的事情。
God can do great things to us that glorify him.
所以我们看大卫到底他心里是在想什么,他怎么有这个胆量呢?
Let's look more carefully at what was in David's heart that gave him such great courage.
我们看37节。
Please read verse 37.
我们36, 37,
verses 36 and 37. Your servant has killed both lion and bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine will be like one of them, seeing he has defied the armies of the living God. Moreover, David said, The Lord who delivered me from the paw of the lion and from the paw of the bear, he will deliver me from the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said to David, Go, and the Lord be with you.
这个地方啊, 大卫在提到他过去牧羊的经验。
David recalled his experience as a shepherd.
诗篇23篇说, 我虽然行过死荫的幽谷, 我也不怕。
In Psalm 23, the psalmist says, Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil.
大卫不是只讲理论。
David did not just speak in theory.
这一句话本身包括他的体验。
And these words of his included his own experience.
当理论加上个人的体验, 这个理论就很有力量。
When theory is accompanied by personal experience, then these words are very powerful.
那到底大卫的体验是什么?
What was David's personal experience?
他在牧羊的时候看到狮子, 然后看到, 熊来。
when he was a shepherd, he saw the bears and the lions come.
你看，一般牧羊人大概就溜走了，爬到树上去了。
A hired shepherd would probably run away and climb up the tree.
为着一两条羊被狮子被狼咬到，那是划不来的。
It's not worth to be killed by a lion or a bear for some sheep.
但是大卫上前去把羊抢出来，把狮子熊都打死。
But David went forward and killed the lion and the bear.
他知道这是神帮助他的。
And he knew that the Lord had delivered him.
所以有这个经验。
He had this experience.
现在面对哥利亚，他就不怕。
Now he was not afraid before Goliath.
哥利亚大概如狮子吧。
Goliath could be compared to a lion.
有谁能够空手打死狮子呢？
Who could kill a lion barehand?
但是有神同在，大卫却做得到。
But with the Lord beside him, David was able to do it.
所以在我们看再回来看十七章的四十七节。
Let's come back to chapter 17, verse 47. Then all this assembly shall know that the Lord does not save with sword and spear.For the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hands.
47节大卫说，神使人得胜，不是用刀用枪。
David said in verse 47, that the Lord does not save with sword and spear.
因为征战的胜败全在乎神。
For the battle is the Lord's.
所以这个征战会不会胜，到最后虽然大卫出去打战，但是到最后是神在决定的。
Even though David was the one fighting, it is the Lord who decides victory.
神如果要让他得胜，他就可以得胜。
If the Lord wills, he will be victorious.
所以不在乎刀枪。
Therefore, the Lord does not save with sword and spear.
最后一句他必将你们交在我们手里。
And lastly, he said, he will give you into our hands.
如果神把哥利亚交给大卫，大卫就得胜了。
If the Lord delivers Goliath into David's hand, David will be victorious.
所以大卫很清楚啊，如果神把哥利亚交给他，他就可以把哥利亚打死。
David knew very clearly that if the Lord delivered Goliath into his hand, he could easily kill Goliath.
所以出去征战，这是人的本分。
It is man's duty, therefore, to go out to battle.
但是人做不到的，神用他的能力来补足。
But God will do.
人做不到的，神用能力来补足。
And with His power, God will help. God will do whatever is humanly impossible.
所以大卫能够用一个石头把哥利亚打死。
With one stone, therefore, David was able to kill Goliath.
那除掉以色列百姓的耻辱。
And this removed the disgrace from the Israelites.
也是整个周围的人都知道，他们所拜的是又真又活的神。
And all the surrounding nations were able to see that the Israelites worshipped the true and living God.
所以我们知道大卫是合神心意的人。
As we know, David was a man after God's own heart.
他整个心就是要讨神喜欢。
He wholeheartedly wanted to please God.
为着神的荣耀而征战。
He fought for the glory of God.
依靠神而征战。
He trusted in God and fought the battle.
到最后完成了他的目标，让神得到荣耀。
In the end, he accomplished his goal and brought glory to God.
这个是我们今天侍奉神很重要的心态。
This is an important attitude in our ministries today.
隐藏在我们内心的最深处里面。
And this is hidden in the bottommost part of our heart.
我要荣耀神。
Our intention to glorify God.
我要讨神喜欢。
I want to please God and glorify Him.
那我们的侍奉就会蒙神祝福。
Then our ministry will be blessed by God.
来唱诗。
Let us sing Him.
453首。
453。Child
as my Savior, I'm a child of the King. My Father's own Son, the Savior of men, once wandered on earth as the poorest of them. But now he is pleading our pardon on high, that we may be his when he comes by and by. I'm a child of the King, a child of the King, the Jesus my Savior, I'm a child of the King. I'm once an outcast sinner on earth, a sinner by choice and an alien by birth. But I've been adopted, my name's written down, and yet in the mansion, a robe and a crown, I'm a child of the King, a child of the King, with Jesus my Savior, I'm a child of the King. Attend on the cottage, why should I care? They're building a palace for me over there. No exile from home, yet still I may sing, oh glory to God, I'm a child of the King, I'm a child of the King, a child of the King, the Jesus my Savior, I'm a child of the King.
Please be seated.
在大卫的一生里面，可以看到一句话。